Hey, Keegan, just a day after, I guess, that loss, just what kind of comes to mind as you reflect back on the series and the season overall?
I mean, it was a hard-fought series, mentally and physically, I think, for both teams. And obviously, at the end of the day, you want to be the last team on top. That's always everyone's goal towards the end of the year, and we fell short of that. So, I mean, obviously, a lot of our guys were down and knew that we let a chance go. So, but we know that with our team still young, that we have a good future ahead.
Keegan, it was a historic rookie season for you, but I wonder what's made you smile the most this season? Because we haven't seen you smile a lot, bud.
Yeah, I mean, probably just being with my teammates on a day-to-day basis. I think just the guys that we had in our locker room, it's just been really fun to go to work with every day. And that's been, I feel like, the most fun that I've had throughout this season, just the behind-the-scenes, being with them in practice in the locker room, things like that.
Keegan, a lot of the guys maybe hitting the free agency market talked about how this is home for them, and they feel like that this is, you know, a place that they could call home. For you, coming off of your rookie year, how does maybe Sacramento, does Sacramento feel like home to you?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's probably one of the best starting points I could have had starting in the NBA, Sacramento. And, I mean, they brought me in as the fans as well as the people in the organization. So I'm incredibly blessed to be able to be picked by them at four in last year's draft, and I feel like I've been put in the best situation possible.
You know, Keegan, it's not often a rookie gets to start in the NBA, play a lot of minutes, play in the playoffs, and then go to seven games against defending champions. I'm curious for you, what do you think you get out of this experience from this season, and maybe how does it shape your offseason?
Yeah, I mean, throughout this playoff series, I just became more and more confident. And doing different things on the court. And honestly, you're going against one of the best offensive teams of all time. You just have to stay on your toes defensively. And offensively, they know how to do different things scheming-wise. And I was able to do different things this series that probably most people haven't seen in the regular season on both sides of the court. So, I mean, if anything, this series made me more confident in anything. And my ability to move forward and my ceiling of how good I can be in the NBA.
Keegan, what's your offseason going to look like? There's some of the things that you like to work on. Are you going to be working with Domantas Sabonis offseason?
Yeah. I mean, I'll be working with Domas a lot this offseason, just fine-tuning different things like that. And for myself, I feel like there's really not one specific area where I feel like I'm established at. I know that I have a lot of areas in the game of basketball where I need to get better at and where I can better myself. So for me, it's just being able to look at statistics, look at film and different things like that, and break down what I need to work on. And I know that it'll be a big offseason for me.
Keegan, a couple quick ones. The first one, it seemed like in game four a switch flipped for you. Was it just confidence or seeing the shot going in, or what changed that led to the success that you had throughout the remainder of the series?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like that was a big turning point for me. Was in game four. And, I mean, throughout the series, I felt fine. The first couple games, guys got going. Malik got going the first game. Trey got going the first game, too. And, I mean, the third game, I got in foul trouble early, and I was trying to start that game out aggressive with a couple shots early. I think I took three shots in the first 6 minutes. But at that point, I knew that I could be aggressive. I could be aggressive smartly throughout the rest of the games. And I just try to put my imprint on the game, no matter if it was rebounding the basketball to get me going, if it was making shots to get me going, just figuring out something that would get me moving, and that sparked in game four.
I figure you're probably going to deal with this all summer, but your brother Kris expected to be drafted. Who knows where he's going to end up, but to you, just how cool is that, and your family preparing to have two brothers in the NBA at the same time?
Yeah, it'll be special for my family. I'm excited. I'm gonna go work out with him in the next couple of days, just to get him ready for the draft, the combine, and things like that. So, and also the workouts that he'll have to go to. So, just for me, just I've been through the circus before. I've been through the pre-draft stuff. I've been through the NBA season. So, whatever I can do to help him get better and help him be more ready for the NBA is what I'll do.
Keegan, two questions. One, like HB, I just wonder, like, what you've taken from him, what you've learned from him, stuff he does on the floor, off the floor. Is he a guy you kind of look to as somebody that you can kind of pick up some things from?
Yeah, I mean, he's been a big figure, not only in Sacramento but the state of Iowa. Just being a guy that came from Iowa to the NBA was a guy that I knew that I could just look at and kind of try to resemble him as best as I can. And just the day-to-day stuff that he does and the routines that he does, I picked up on, I feel like, throughout the year. And I feel like that's kind of helped me become a better player throughout this season, just in my routine, in my day-to-day, the work that I put in, how intricate the work is, and things like that.
And I also wanted to ask you to reflect a little bit on your rookie duties this year. What was the most ridiculous stuff these guys had you doing? What was, you know, was there anything that was enjoyable? Anything you really didn't like?
I mean, I picked up Chick-fil-A every away game. So that kind of put, it was like $300 every single road trip. So that kind of hurt, but, but I mean, they're cool with everything that I did. A bunch of the little stuff I had to do and stuff like that, but they're good people.
Keegan, we saw moments throughout the season where you look like a different player, where you would take over, or you would show flashes of who you can be moving forward. How are you going to manage like that aspect of when it is your time to become something bigger and better for this team, or when it's your time to sit back and just be the three-point shooter, the floor spacer?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it depends on the game, the situation, things like that. But this offseason, I really just want to try and relieve the pressure off Domas and Fox and them trying to create their own shot and at the end of games. And I kind of want to trend to be that guy. I mean, I kind of relate it to my freshman year of college when I was behind Luka Garza, and just kind of had to figure out a path. And obviously, I made that jump to my sophomore year. I mean, it might not be that big of a jump statistics-wise, but whatever I can do to imprint my game onto the game that night is what I'll do to help this team. And I feel like that's a lot of things. So,
sort of along those same lines, I mean, as a rookie, I take it a lot of it is trying to get in where you fit in. But going forward as a foundational piece of this franchise, do you think about the implication of like, okay, I need to take a step forward in this area in leadership and whatever it is away from the court to be sort of a franchise pillar that maybe De'Aaron and Domas have become?
Yeah. I mean, obviously there's a lot of different things as a rookie. It's tough to be a leader when you got guys that have been here, have been established before. And I know that being a leader, you have to be able to do actions before you can say something or do something for your team. So that's something that I know that I have to establish within our organization. And I'm excited to obviously learn from Domas or from Fox, HB, what it takes to be a leader in this league. So I feel like I've had a good stepping stone so far.
Yeah, Keegan, Davion shared in preseason that everybody was telling him you're still a rookie until you play your first game of your second season. So are you still a rookie right now? Have they been telling you the same thing?
Yeah, according to the Kings players, yeah, I'm still a rookie until the first regular season game next year.
Gotcha. And then another sort of more loose one for you is everybody talks about like a welcome to the NBA moment. And I'm curious if you had one this year and if you wouldn't mind sharing.
Yeah, I think it was really just my first preseason game. I mean, you don't really get a chance to check in, and the assistant coach tells you to go guard LeBron James. And you step on the court and you have LeBron, AD, and Russ on the court together. And I feel like that's kind of what every kid dreams of growing up. And I think that was kind of my first welcome to the NBA moment, just be on the court with those guys. But I mean, it was a cool moment for me.
Just kind of following up on, you know, obviously your brother going through this, as you help prepare him, knowing him the way you do, what do you feel he's going to be most impacted by in just the whole process leading up to the draft?
Yeah, I think just him continuing to stay healthy is the biggest thing in the NBA. I think the biggest thing is just being available when your team needs you, and not having those injuries where you're sitting out and things like that. So that's a big thing for him, and I've stressed that to him a lot. And also just the physicality that you need on both sides of the basketball, because every guy in this league can score. So there's no time where you can take a play off or guard a guy, and he's just not going to do anything. So just him kind of flipping that mindset, I feel like it's mental more than anything for him at this point. So,
would you like having him here in Sacramento, or would you prefer the Eastern Conference?
I mean, I wouldn't mind him being in Sacramento, but let the chips fall where they may. So,
Keegan, we're months removed now. Can you tell us what happened to your thumb?
Yeah. So it's the exact same. I mean, it's I had a chipped bone and a torn ligament. So pretty much the exact same thing that Fox has. So. Yeah, yeah. It's, I'd say it's more to Domas. So we both had the thumb issue, and yeah, I had a fracture and a torn ligament, so I just had to play through that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's good to go.
Was it a bulging?
Yeah.